So Marvel Studios' newest feature is a special presentation for Disney Plus. Finally stepping into the horror corner of their comics universe, Werewolf by Night is a pretty cool new TV movie that's streaming now on Disney Plus. Now, this is the first feature of its kind from Marvel, and for the moment seems to focus on a new narrative that seems separate from the rest of the MCU. Werewolf by Night is full of new ideas, new characters, and brand new objects that may go on to have larger significance within the Marvel Cinematic Universe. One of those things is the sort of MacGuffin of the Werewolf by Night movie, the Bloodstone. If you're interested in the comic book origin of Werewolf by Night, then be sure to check out my video explainer on Werewolf by Night and his first encounter with the hero Moon Knight. Don't worry about looking for it. I'll be sure to put a link in the description. Now, the following will contain a lot of spoilers for the Marvel Studios Werewolf by Night special presentation. If you don't want spoilers, check out the trailer and our review on the movie blog website and then return just for discussion. So, Werewolf by Night begins with the funeral of a famous monster hunter, Ulysses Bloodstone. A group of renowned hunters gather to honor him, but also to fight for the right to earn the coveted Bloodstone. While it would usually pass to Ulysses' heir and daughter, Elsa Bloodstone, she's viewed as something of an outcast and a disappointment. Instead, there's a tournament in which various monster hunters are invited to compete for the chance to claim the Bloodstone. Throughout the movie, the Bloodstone is seen as a magical item that everyone desires. Now, there are several magical items in the MCU, like the Eye of Agamotto and the Crown of Surtur, not to mention the Infinity Stones. Each of these items have proven to be extremely dangerous in the wrong hands. So let's look at the Bloodstone's comic book origins to determine what exactly it is. The history of the Bloodstone in Marvel Comics is directly tied to the character of Ulysses Bloodstone. The Bloodstone gem is actually a piece of meteorite that landed on Earth during the Hyborian Age in 8250 BC. This is a fictional era of Earth's history, the same era that the adventures of Conan the Barbarian are set in. The meteorite was controlled by an evil alien entity called the Hellfire Helix. Its goal was to conquer the Earth, you know, the usual villain stuff. To do so, it sent its agent, the Ulixil Quante Sin, to Earth to find the meteorite. But before it could get to the meteorite, a regular hunter-gatherer kind of human found it. The Uluxi and this human fought over the meteorite, and in the chaos, they end up shattering it into many pieces during their battle. One such piece lodged within the human's chest, causing an explosion that kills his whole tribe, but somehow grants him immortality. With other powers, the human vows revenge on the Uluxi for the death of his tribe. That piece of meteor is the Bloodstone. And yep, you guessed it, that human grows up to then become Ulysses Bloodstone. With the Bloodstone now a part of him, Ulysses goes on to become one of history's most ruthless and resourceful warriors. Being immortal, Ulysses had time on his side, allowing him to become an expert fighter, weapon specialist, and linguist, also amassing a massive fortune. He used all of his resources to mostly hunt down his sworn foe, Ulysses, in an attempt to finally avenge his tribe. During their encounters, Ulysses would summon monsters from different dimensions for Ulysses to fight. Over time, dispatching all of the Ulysses' monsters gained Ulysses a reputation as a monster hunter, and thus the legacy grew. Ulysses' comic book origins didn't get buried and muddled as he had other adventures crossing paths with many other Marvel characters like Iron Man. But it's this monster hunter legacy of his comic book story that seems to be the basis of the character in Werewolf by Night. In the comic books, the Bloodstone in Ulysses' chest gave off magical energy, giving him the usual barrage of superpowers: super strength, stamina, speed, reflexes, and other superhuman senses. It also acted as a healing factor, allowing him to heal from fatal wounds and providing immunity to disease. Ulysses could even regrow limbs if he had to. The comics even hint that Ulysses may have received psionic powers from the Bloodstone, but they're not entirely clear on that part. In Werewolf by Night, we see the Bloodstone used in different ways. Firstly, the movie starts with the funeral of Ulysses Bloodstone. Now, we're never given an exact explanation on how Ulysses has died. This gives the impression that Ulysses may not have been an immortal being if he presumably died of old age. The Bloodstone also seems like it's only safe to be used by humans. or possibly just non-monsters. Halfway through Werewolf by Night, we see this when Jack goes to pick it up and the Bloodstone just blasts him away. The reaction of Ulysses' wife, Verusa, is that it only reacts like that with monsters. Verusa also is seen later using the Bloodstone to force Jack's transformation into the werewolf, even without the full moon. She also uses it to attack Jack, blasting energy beams from it to keep him at bay. In conclusion, I'm excited to see how the Bloodstone will factor into the larger fabric of the MCU and how much of it will use from its comic book origins. It's definitely a very powerful object that many have and will continue to want. If it's anything like the Infinity Stones, the Ten Rings, Ms. Marvel's bangles, or the Darkhold, then this is certainly not the last we've seen of this Bloodstone. Werewolf by Night ends with the Bloodstone in the possession of Elsa Bloodstone, Ulysses' daughter, making it almost a foregone conclusion that we will definitely see a lot more of Elsa. Oh, and probably Jack too. Not to mention more Man Thing, please and thank you. Anyway, that's all I have for this one. If you guys like these types of video explainers, you want to see more, do me a favor. Make sure you hit that like button. Make sure you subscribe. Otherwise, I'll check you guys later. Peace.